Hello friends, welcome to the Viva House of Anatomy. Today we will discuss the quadrant of the abdomen. Why we require to divide the abdomen into the different quadrant? To describe the inner structure on the surface, the abdomen is divided into the different quadrant. Now there are two patterns to divide the anti-abdominal wall into different quadrant. That is, first is a four quadrant topographical pattern in which there are two lines which will divide the abdominal wall into four quadrant. The lines are anterior median line passing through the umbilicus, that is a vertical line, and the horizontal line that also passes through the umbilicus at the level of intervertebral disc between the L3 and the L4. This two lines divide the abdomen into the four quadrant, that is right upper, left upper, right lower and left lower quadrant. The second pattern that is important one, that is a nine quadrant organizational pattern in which there are the four lines which divide the abdominal wall into the nine quadrant. The four lines are two vertical line, that is called a lateral plane, right and the left, and the two horizontal plane. First we talk about the horizontal plane. The first horizontal plane is a transpyloric plane. Transpyloric plane passes between the midpoint of a suprasternal nose and the pubic symphysis, the approximately one hand breadth below the Giffey sternum. Okay, now anteriorly this line passes through the tip of a nine costal cartilage, the tip of a nine rib, and posteriorly it will passes through the body of a L1 vertebra at its lower end. This is the transpyloric plane. Now the organ present at the level of the transpyloric plane are the fundus of the gallbladder, the pylorus of the stomach, the origin of the supramesenteric artery, the hilum of the both the kidney, and the lower end of the spinal cord. Second is the transtubercular plane. The transtubercular plane passes through the tubercle of a iliac crest, and that lies at the level of upper border of a body of L5 vertebrae. So these are the two horizontal planes. Now talking about the two lateral planes, the right and the left. They are called as a midclavicular line. Passes through the middle of the clavicle above, and below it passes through the mid-inguinal point. Now the mid-inguinal point is a midpoint between the pubic symphysis and the anterior superior iliac spine. So this is the right and the left lateral plane. So this four plane divide the abdominal wall into the nine quadrants. Now the nine quadrants divided into three vertical region, that is a median region, right and the left vertical region. Now the other zone in the median region are, the upper zone is known as an epigastric region, middle is an umbilical region, and the lower is a hypogastric region. Whereas in the right and the left, this region from above downwards are the right and the left hypochondriac region, the lumbar region or renal region, and the iliac region, right and the left. Now we see the main content of this nine quadrant. Starting from the right hypochondriac, it consists of a liver and the gallbladder. Whereas in the left hypochondriac region contains the spleen, stomach, and the left colic flexor. Whereas in the epigastric region, it consists of the spleen, the stomach, duodenum, and the pancreas. The right lumbar region will consist of the ascending colon, right kidney, and the right ureter. Whereas the left lumbar region consists of a descending colon, left kidney, and the left ureter. Umbilical region will contain the aorta, inferior vena cava, the coils of intestines, and the stomach. The right iliac region consists of the cecum and the vermiform appendix, The left iliac region consists of a sigmoid colon, whereas the last hypogastric region consists of a urinary bladder, coils of the intestine and enlarged uterus. So these are the main content of all the nine quadrant. Now we see the one important structure which is seen in the anti-abdominal wall, that is the umbilicus. Okay, that present in the umbilical area. The umbilicus is a normal scar which is present in the anti-abdominal wall, which is formed due to the remnant of a root of the umbilical cord. Now, the position of the umbilicus is a variable, but in the healthy individual, on an average, it lies at the level of an intervertebral disc between the L3 and the L4 vertebra in the anterior median vertical line. Now we see the important anatomical importance of the umbilicus. First, the umbilicus is supplied by the T10 segment of the spinal cord. Second, the plane of the umbilicus, horizontally, it acts as a watershed for the venous and the lymphatic drainage of the abdomen. Means, from the plane of the umbilicus, the venous and the lymphatic will drain either above or below the plane of a umbilicus, like a watershed. The third important structure, the umbilicus, third importance of umbilicus is, it is an important structure at which the tributaries of the portal vein and that of the systemic vein will unite, will make anastomosis, which is called as a portocaval anastomosis. Now, in case of the portal hypertension, this portocaval anastomosis will be opened up. This anastomosis will be dilated. So you can see the dilated vein which is radiating from the umbilicus in case of the portal hypertension, which is known as a caput medusa. Now the second embryological importance, umbilicus is a meeting point of a four embryonic fold, that are two lateral and one head and second fourth tail end. Second important embryological, it is also a meeting point of a three system, that is a gastrointestinal, excretory and the vascular. So this is all about the quadrant of a abdomen. Thank you.
If you like this video, like it and share with your friends. And to get the regular update on the anatomy videos, please subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon.